All right, hope everybody's having a good day. I'm here to tell you about Saint of Me by the Rolling Stones. Here on the cover, you see a picture of the Stones back in the 60s, and then a current day picture. I think that picture on the right there is from a couple years ago. I'll explain to you who all these guys are if you don't know by now. The Rolling Stones, they were founded in 1960. They're still playing today, still touring. They're probably going to cut it off pretty soon, though, but they're one of the most respected bands in history. They originated in London because all the members were located like around London, so that's where they practiced and played out of. Their inspiration was Muddy Waters. He was a blues artist way back in the day. He had a song called Rolling Stones, and they just loved it, and it was an inspiration, so they named their band after it. That song also was big in determining their style of music. That was a blues song, and they took that song, and they're known as the British Badasses because they play more rock and roll than other bands at the time, like more hard rock. So they mixed the blues and the rock, and that's how they came up with their unique style. They have 29 albums that they recorded, which is a pretty decent amount. The members shown here, Mick Jagger on the left is the singer, Ronnie Wood next to him, the bass player, Keith Richards, the guitarist, and Charlie Watts, the drummer. Throughout the band's history, they won or were nominated for over 60 awards. In 1995, they won 2 Grammys, one for their Voodoo Lounge album and their Love Is Strong music video. They were also nominated for 8 Grammys from the 80s to 2006. One of them being the album that this song is off of, called Bridges to Babylon. In 2005, they won the World Music Award. They were considered the greatest touring band of all time. That's probably their proudest award. And they also won the Brit Award for Best British Group. Mick Jagger grew up in Dartford, Kent. Actually went to grade school with Keith Richards. Before the Stones were together, he jumped around from band to band. He played a lot of blues music. He sang a lot of blues. He is a co-founder of the Stones. I'll get into that once I talk about Keith Richards a little bit. Also, not a lot of people know this, he tried out a solo career after 20 years of being with the Stones, and Keith Richards finally got in his face after a while and was like, you need to come back, like it's not the same. Keith Richards also grew up with Mick Jagger. They went to the same school, but after a while, Keith Richards moved while Mick Jagger was out playing music and everything. And what I'm about to tell you is kind of crazy, so good thing you're all sitting down. But the Rolling Stones, one of the most known bands of all time, actually started by accident. This is because Keith Richards and Mick Jagger met on a train in the 1960s, and they were just catching up. They hadn't seen each other since grade school, so they got to talking about music and what kind they liked. They both liked blues and rock and roll. So they scheduled a time to play together, and ever since, the Stones were created. Keith Richards, though, crazy guy, all about partying, living the rock and roll lifestyle, but he took it a little too far. He got addicted to heroin, and that can play a major role in ruining a band. But luckily, his band got around him and gave him the support to come back. So it's pretty inspirational what he did. Ronnie Wood from Hillingdon, London. He played for a few other bands, The Birds and Faces. Always a bassist. He came out with a few solo albums that didn't get much attention. He had much more fame with the Stones. He was also a gifted painter. With being a gifted musician, he held art exhibits throughout all across the United States. And he was, I think that's not good. He was inducted to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame twice. Charlie Watts from Wembley spent a lot of time with his grandmother due to family complications. He was always a big jazz fan. He also played some blues music with Alexis Corners Incorporated. And he also was part of an orchestra, which was led by him. Kind of interesting fact about him. You can tell just in all the pictures you see of him, he's got a classy look to his face. All right, so now that all that's covered, we're going to talk about the song a little bit. This song was written in 1997 by Mick Jagger and Keith Richards off the album Bridges to Babylon, which was one of the 8 Grammy nominations that I mentioned earlier. So before I play it, I'm going to hand you guys some lyrics. I know Mick Jagger's accent's a little hard to understand. So this song is in strophic form. When you hear it playing, you'll hear an intro, you'll know it's an intro. It's very quiet, and it kind of crescendos into the first strophe, which contains a verse and a chorus. And once that chorus ends, the second strophe begins, where the melody comes back to the first verse, and another verse comes. And then there's a bridge that sets up Keith Richards' guitar solo. And finally, the third strophe is a verse, a chorus, and then the chorus is extended until the end of the song. So I'm going to play it here. Just try to see where these points between strophes are. Also, you can look at the lyrics, but I'm going to play a music video too, so whatever you want to do while I'm playing it.
Make a sign of me.
if you watch the video, first off, you know the Stones get all the girls from those goofy dance moves. But also, if you read the lyrics, Mick Jagger's trying to get a point across. He brings up saints of the past and all the sin that they performed. And basically, you'll never make a saint of me. He's saying that he sinned. I mean, he will never be able to consider himself a saint. So that's pretty much the message of the song. And that's all I have for you.